We started the Ampersand Pantry Project to provide food to folks who, because of COVID, just didn't have it and wasn't available. And the idea is freshly prepared in a commercial kitchen, safe lunches that we distribute 7 days a week at about the rate of about 300 a day. And as of a day or two ago, we were at 65,000 lunches that we have distributed. 2020 has been, if there's a catchword for it, surprise. And it's just been surprise not only in the form of our having this terrible COVID pandemic, but our response to it, which grew out of my building some simple pantry boxes, like the little free libraries, that had its own purpose. But the big surprise was this pandemic coming and the need people had. And then the next surprise was how big the need was. And then this next surprise after that was how this community has turned out just unbelievably. And that is just so satisfying. I just can't tell you how wonderful it's been.
What I love most about supporting the Loudoun community is the strength of partnerships and relationships and commitments within the community. And one of my favorite phrases that I think epitomizes that is that community is not the beneficiary, community is the solution. When we started the Community Emergency Relief Fund, we had all kinds of backing. In fact, there are thousands of people behind me on this side and thousands of people behind me on this side. Here, there were so many individuals who immediately began giving and are still giving to the Community Emergency Relief Fund. Some super notable: Google, the County of Loudoun, and the Visit Loudoun Foundation. And through that, some great partnerships in the nonprofit community, particularly through the Loudoun Catholic Charities offices and Loudoun Cares, began to build this partnership that was tremendous. And on this side, thousands of households and nonprofit recipients who received funding to keep their rent paid, their utilities paid, and to keep their lights on.
The Loudoun County Business Interruption Fund, from April to November, was able to provide over $11 million to almost 2,000 businesses. And we were able to do that with the support, starting with the Board of Supervisors and County Administration, with the help of over 90 volunteers. And we were able to do that continuously in that time to try to provide some measure of financial support to our small businesses to survive the pandemic. The business owners, this is, for most of them, this is their life. This is not some corporation off in another state. This is their ability to pay their rent, their mortgage, their utilities, to feed their families. And so that's really what I think a lot of people miss, is that this isn't just helping a nameless business. This is about helping your neighbor. It's about helping your community.
For Loudoun Hunger Relief, I think part of what really makes us stronger together in this community is that we are really a conduit between people who want to help and the people who need the help. And so with our partners, including the Loudoun County Public Schools, all of the other smaller pantries in our community, Blue Ridge Area Food Bank, and our faith congregation partners, all of these folks came together to make sure that people had enough to eat, that no one would be hungry in Loudoun. And I think that is so impressive and so wonderful. I think that the work of Loudoun Hunger Relief and our partners and our community partners who helped us, particularly during this time, to feed so many people, the ability to know that when we go home at night and put our heads on our pillows, that people have food on their plates and food in their bellies, and they have the ability to feed their children, that senior citizens have a meal. I think that's really the important part of the work that we do.
So this year we've created partnerships that we probably would have never had if COVID had not hit. We know that we live in a community that when there's a need, that we'll all kind of join forces to fill that need. We've seen the generosity of the community. We were running an emergency food pantry when the pandemic first hit. We kind of pivoted to meet the needs of the community because there weren't a lot of food access available in the Sterling community. And we were just overwhelmed with the kindness and generosity of the businesses and the individual donors. Every weekend, we would serve about 300 cars in our food pantry drive-through line, and every weekend we would run out of food, diapers, feminine products, and by the next Saturday we were fully stocked again because of the call for help and just people being overwhelmed to want to give back even though they can't physically be at our location.